These are hot buzzwords right now in the research community. There's a lot of research been done with basically animal models. Mm-hmm. And what people talk about at autophagy and apoptosis is basically changing either, you know, regenerating cells from aging cells, regenerating with replacement cells, and
it's
also
kind of the cleaning system, right?
A cleaning system, but also cleaning up internal cellular machinery, particularly involving things called mitochondria. And mitochondria are those little furnaces inside cells that actually do the oxidative energy generation. That's where oxygen is consumed along with either fat or carbohydrate to replace the high energy phosphates, ATP, and creatine phosphate. And so that machinery constantly has to be repaired. And there is evidence that periods of fasting can enhance that process. Sure. There's been less research with well-formulated ketogenic diets done long enough to actually look at that. And again, the turnover of cells and the turnover of mitochondria, that is how frequently they're replaced, is measured in weeks or months, not in a day or two.
Sure.
And so particularly for human... you know, to have human specific results, it takes rigorously done studies, and there aren't that many groups who have been able to sustain ketogenic diets long enough to really look at that. And again, stay tuned, because that's an area where Dr. Volek and his team are on the forefront of doing that research.
Yeah, I think I'm certainly not an expert in this area, but I think autophagy can be stimulated by reduced insulin, increased glucagon, inhibition of mTOR. So it would, I know a lot of the research is in fasting, and ketogenic diets tend to mimic that from a metabolism standpoint in a lot of ways. So I would assume that you would be able to get some similar benefits out of doing it for a long time.